Hello, welcome to this tutorial. Let's see in a very short time everything you need to start using Microsoft Word 2019. Leave us comments with tips and suggestions to improve our next videos dedicated to Microsoft Office. Microsoft Word is a piece of software included in the Office package developed by Microsoft. This is one of the best products to realize documentations, flyers, letters, and reports, with professional tools to adjust the page layout, distribute text, and add objects and illustrations. In this video, we're going to see all the major features you're going to use inside Word. You can also download a sample document in the video description. When opening Word, a startup page shows up. On the left, you get a list with your previous documents made, and on the right, several ready templates you can use to start with a new document. To see all the main tools inside Word, let's start from an empty document by going to Blank Document. The new document shows up with a single page or sheet completely blank. More pages will be added as you go on typing inside. On top, you have the menu bar with several tabs collecting all the features and tools inside Word. At the bottom, other information, such as number of pages and language, including a zoom bar you can use to zoom in and out. To start writing, just click inside your document and type. Word checks each word inside the document, adding uppercase characters on new lines or showing wavy or double underlined text if this is wrong in spelling, grammar, or punctuation. All these corrections are based on the language chosen at the bottom and are never rendered in case you export or print the document. If you right-click on these suggestions, you can apply, ignore these, or add new words to the dictionary. Inside the Word document, you can type standard text, but also add emojis, symbols, and equations. From the Insert tab, you can use Equation to build math expressions by using the Equation tools above. And use Symbol to add math symbols, Greek characters, and unusual accents. On the Symbol dialog box, select the character and use Insert to add it where the flashing pointer is placed. To edit the format of any text, symbol, or expression, you have to select these first. Just click and drag on the characters to select these, or hold down the Shift key and use the left and the right arrow keys to select character per character. You can also double-click on a word to select it directly, or click from the left side of the document to select one or multiple entire lines. Once text is selected, you can edit its format by using either the Quick Dialog box close to your pointer or the Font section inside the Home tab. Adjust the font family, size, and style, adding bold, italic, underlined, subscript, or superscript text. Use font color to apply solid color or any gradient. Text highlight color to color the text background, and text effects and typography to add effects such as outline, shadow, reflection, or glow. For the full list of properties, just click on font. To cut, copy, and paste selected text, just use Ctrl and use X, C, and V respectively. When you paste, the text is pasted where the pointer is. The copy-paste operation is often used to import content from other text files. In case you make any mistake, just use Ctrl and Z to undo. Now, let's see how to adjust the page layout of your document. The page layout describes the page setup that the text content should respect as you type in. All these options are collected under the Layout tab. You can use margins to set the fixed distance between the text and the extreme edges of the paper. Orientation to change the page orientation. Size to change the basic dimensions of the paper. And columns to distribute text inside columns. In this way, once the first column is completely filled, you will start typing on the second column. The ruler, placed at the top and on the left, measures the document width and length, using the measurement unit chosen by your language system. If you need to change the unit, go to File, Options, and then to Advanced, under Show Measurements in Units Of. If you do not see the ruler, just go to View, and then to Ruler. The ruler is divided in two parts. The dark ones, called margins, fix the distance between the page edges and the text content. The white one shows where text can spread. You can also click and drag on the edges to customize the page margins as you need. In case of multiple text columns, you can get multiple white and dark parts inside the ruler. Let's see how to adjust the text distribution inside your document. The text content is made by several lines grouped together called paragraphs. Each paragraph is created once a new sentence starts from a new line with the Enter key. You can take a look at all the paragraphs inside your document by using the Show Hide button. Each paragraph has its own distribution and alignment options that can be the same or different from other paragraphs. Just click once within a paragraph to select it and start editing it. Inside Paragraph, under the Home tab, choose the alignment for its text, such as left, center, or right. Use Justify to fit the text spacing with the full document width. Use Line and Paragraph spacing to adjust the distance between each line inside the paragraph, including the distance from the previous and the following paragraph. Use shading to add a colored background and borders to add contours. In addition, if you go to the Layout tab, you can use Indent to add or decrease indentation on both sides of the page and spacing to adjust the distance between the current paragraph and the previous one before or the next one after. The ruler is also used to adjust the text distribution of the current paragraph through its left and right markers. The right marker is used to adjust the right indentation, whereas the left marker is made by several parts. If you click and drag the top marker, you will adjust the indentation just on the first line of the paragraph. If you move the bottom marker, you adjust all the paragraph lines, including the first one. If you move while holding Shift down, you exclude the first line that will not move. As you make these adjustments, you can hold down the Alt key to get instant measurements on the ruler itself. Word has advanced tools to make lists inside the paragraph section. Use bullets to make bulleted lists with symbols and markers on each point. Numbering to make lists with numbers or letters increasing. And multi-level lists to make lists with other lists inside. Click on the down arrow next to each button to change the symbols or characters to use. And use the ruler markers to adjust the indentation for each single point inside the list. Use the top marker to place the list symbol and the bottom marker to place the whole list. Hold down the Shift key to adjust the text content only. Inside Word, you can use headers and footers to insert page numbers, any date or information on all the existing pages and all the future ones you will add inside your document. The headers and the footers are placed within the top and the bottom margins of the page, respectively, where the left ruler shows its dark sides. For example, to type inside a footer, just double-click at the very bottom side of the page. At this point, the Header and Footer Tools tab opens with all the options to add increasing page numbers, dates, or any document information. To apply, just double-click outside. The content color may be lighter in this region, but this is printed and exported with its original color in the end. In case you add page numbers by using page number in the top left corner, these will increase page after page automatically. You can create interactive chapters and titles by using the headings. On a new line, open the Home tab, and under Styles, choose one of the headings available, starting from 1, Main Title, to the subtitles 3, 4, and so on. Then, type inside the document and edit its format by using the font section as seen for the standard text. These headings are not just simple titles. These are used to locate and separate the document into chapters. For example, you can click on its left arrow to hide all its content up to the next heading at the same or superior level, or you can open the navigation panel by clicking on the document pages at the bottom and, under Headings, click on each heading to locate it inside the document. In addition, you can use Insert Footnote under the References tab to add a number above the text line and a written note at the bottom of the page right before the footer. On the text content, you can also apply interactive links you can click to open websites or go to specific parts of your document. Under the Insert tab, use Link to add links to the selected piece of text. You can paste a direct hyperlink on address, create a link to open a local file directly, drive to a heading title within the current document, or even create a new document or email. Pieces of text with these links are shown in light blue color and underlined. To break the link, just right-click on it and go to Remove Hyperlink. Inside the document, you can also add extra objects, such as tables, shapes, and pictures, by using their buttons inside the Insert tab. Use Table to import a simple table, specifying the number of rows and columns first. Then, type inside each cell, and use the Design tab to adjust the table appearance, color and borders, and the Layout tab to add or remove rows and columns on the left, and adjust the cell content distribution on the right. You can move the table freely by clicking and dragging from the top left corner button. Use Shapes to create polygons, arrows, and other shapes by clicking and dragging on the workspace. In addition, if you drop a text box, you can type inside it and add pieces of text that are completely independent from the rest of the document. You can adjust the text properties and distribution by using the Home tab as seen before. Use Pictures to browse and import pictures inside the document. Under the Format tab, you can apply corrections, effects, and even contours. Use Crop to crop the picture by clicking and dragging the black nodes on it. You can also draw freehand with different styles by using the Draw tool under the Draw tab. To stop drawing, just disable the Draw tool. All these shapes, pieces of text, pictures, and drawings are independent objects that you can select by clicking on these. At this point, you can move by clicking and dragging, scale by using their nodes, and rotate by using the arrow button on top. As you select an object, the Layout options appears as well, used to adjust the relationship between the object and the text content. Choose Inline to place the object in line with the text, or Text Wrapping to leave the object independent from the text, placed in front, behind it, with or without any extra distance if needed. You can also use the Format tab to adjust fill, add any outline, and in case of text boxes, apply fill, outline, and effects to each of the characters inside the box. As you add tables, pictures, and equations, you may need to add formatted descriptions or captions below these. To add captions, go to References and then to Insert Caption. On Label, choose Figure to describe a picture and Equation Table to describe either an equation or a table. Choose the caption to use on top and then click on OK to type the description. Captions get an increasing number automatically as you go on adding captions. You can also use cross-reference to add links to specific elements of your document, such as headings and captions. To save and export your document, just go to File and then to Save As. Choose where to save your document and define the file name. Select a DocX file format to save your document as a Word file to open and edit it another time, or PDF to export or print the document as a PDF file. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel to discover more and free outstanding guides for Microsoft Office.